shortage of medical supplies. People in Wuhan lining up in front of a drugstore to buy a surgical mask. A notice at a supermarket in Beijing which says each person can only buy one pack of surgical mask and one bottle of 84 disinfected liquid a day. As the epidemic accelerated and the mainland market saw a shortage of the face mask due to the increased need by far from the public, and it was reported that Shanghai customer had to queue for nearly an hour to buy a pack of face mask which was sold out in another half an hour. Some stores hoarded supplies, driving up prices, so the market regulator cracked down on such acts. The shortage will not be revealed until late February when most workers returned from the New Year vacation, according to Lai Lehman, an expert in the industry. On 22 January 2020, Taobao, China's largest e-commerce platform owned by the Alibaba Group, said that all face masks on Taobao and the Tmall would not be allowed to increase in price. Special subsidies would be provided to the retailers. Also, Alibaba Health Urgent Drugs Delivery Services would not be closed during the Spring Festival. JD, another leading Chinese e-commerce platform, said, "We are actively working to ensure supply and price stability from the sources, storage and distribution platform control and so on, and while fully ensuring price stability for JD on commodities. JD.com has also exercised strictly control over the commodities on the JD's platform. The third party vendors selling face masks are prohibited from the rising prices. Once it is confirmed that the price of the third party vendor have increased abnormally, JD will immediately remove the offending the commodities for the shelves and dealing with the offending vendors accordingly." Other major e-commerce platforms including Shanning.com and Pinduoduo also promised to keep the price of health products stable. Economy. China's economy growth is expected to slow by up to 1.1% in the first half of 2020 as an economy activity is negatively affected by the new coronavirus pandemic, according to the Morgan Stanley study cited by the Reuters. But on 1st February 2020, the People's Bank of China said that the impact of the epidemic on the Chinese economy was temporary and that is fundamental of China's long-term positive and high-quality growth remained unchanged. Due to the outbreak, the Shanghai Stock Exchange and the Shenzhen Stock Exchange announced that with the approval of the China Security Regulatory Commission, the closing time for the Spring Festival will be extended to 2 February and trading will resume on 3 February. Before that, on 23rd January, the last trading day of the shares before the Spring Festival, all three major stock indexes opened lower, creating a drop of about 3%, and the Shanghai Composite Index fell below 3,000 on 2 February, the first trading day after the holidays. The three major indexes even set a record low, opening of about 8% by the end of the day, declining and narrowed slightly to about 7%. The Shenzhen Index fell below 10,000 points. A total of 3,177 stocks in the two markets fell. The People's Bank of China and State Administration of the Foreign Exchange have announced that the interbank renminbi foreign exchange market, the foreign currency to market, and the foreign currency market will extend their holidays closed until 2 February 2020 when the market opened on 3rd February. The renminbi was now depreciating against major foreign currencies. The central parity rate of the renminbi against the US dollar opened at 6.9249, a drop of 373 basis points from the previous trading day. It fell below the 7.00 then an hour after the opening and closed at the 7.0257.